In this video, we'll discuss about a dense connective tissue, that is bone. Bone, we'll classify this bone into various types like compact bone and spongy bone. But before that, we'll talk about a long bone. Suppose we draw the structure of this long bone and we know that it has two main parts. The head part, which is at the end, and a narrow shaft part, which is in the middle. So these parts, they are given names. The head part is known as the epiphysis and the shaft part is known as diaphysis. And in between, there is this zone of growth where the bone elongation takes place. And in this diaphysis part, there is a cavity. And this cavity is known as the bone marrow cavity. It is called bone marrow cavity. And in this cavity is filled the yellow bone marrow. So what is found here is yellow bone marrow. And this yellow bone marrow, it stores fat, and because of this, the color of this bone marrow is yellow. In this part, that is in the epiphysis part, there is again bone marrow, and that bone marrow is in between the cells. Once we understand the structure, we'll know where this marrow is. And here is the red bone marrow. And red bone marrow is the erythropoietic structure. It is erythropoietic tissue basically. That means red bone marrow is erythropoietic. That means this is the tissue where erythropoiesis takes place. This is the place where RBC or other blood cells are formed. So this is the basic structure, and the head part, that is the epiphysis part, is also covered with a cartilaginous cap. So there is a padding of this cartilaginous tissue, which is normally at the head region. Now when we want to see the structure of bone, we take a section. That means we're going to cut this bone into this, in this plane, so that we see a transverse structure. So what we see is a bone which is cut like this, and the inner part is filled with the yellow bone marrow. This is the marrow cavity, and we find the yellow bone marrow because it is the cavity which has been cut. The bone is covered by a fibrous sheath on the outer side and on the inner side also. So the outer layer is known as periostea, and the inner one is known as endoostea. These are the two fibrous layers. Now to understand the structure of the bone, we will have to enlarge only this much part, or let me take this part so that the orientation remains the same. So we are just going to enlarge this part so that we are able to see the inner structure. But before that, we need to know what exactly is going to be visible to us inside. In this long part, that is in this compact long bone, we would find some tube-like structures, and these tube-like structures are actually Heversian canals. So where are these Heversian canals? I'm going to make this bone little more fat. So if I make the bone like this, even fat, so that we are able to understand the structure, and we draw this marrow cavity here. So this part is that hard bony part. In this part, there are these tube-like areas. There is no membrane or anything. It is just a longitudinal canal, which is here. So this is the longitudinal canal. And if we take a section, we would see these canals cut. So this is the Haversian canal. Haversian canals. And these canals, they run a vertical or along the length of the long bone. And through this Haversian canal run blood vessels, nerve fibers, so that the cells which are in this compact region, they would get the nourishment. These Haversian canals, let me make one more Haversian canal here. These Haversian canals, they are connected with each other. And these connections are oblique connections. So if we connect these two Haversian canals, the connection is not straight. The connection is in the form of an obliquely placed, again, a canal. And this canal is known as Volkmann's canal. And the function of all these canals is so that the blood vessels and nerve fibers can run all through this compact tissue. What all structures are going to be seen inside? It is a tissue, connective tissue, so we would find cells. There are different types of cells. The first is known as osteoblast. Then the second type is known as osteocyte. And we also find one more cell which is called osteoclast. Osteoclast. Now, we need to understand the functioning of all these cells and then we'll be able to draw them properly. Osteoblast cells, they start secreting the hard material around the or in the bone. Once they get surrounded by this hard bony matrix, they themselves change into osteocytes. So osteoblasts actually change into osteocytes. Osteocyte function is maintenance of the bony material. So what is the function of osteoblasts? They secrete bony matrix and change into osteocytes once they get surrounded by the bony material. Then the function of osteocyte is to maintain the bony material. And now, what is the function of these osteoclasts? Osteoclasts are normally eating cells. That means they would remove old osteocytes. Once the osteocytes are old, they need to be removed. So one is bone making cell, then there are bone eating cells. Now from where do these cells arise? They arise from stem cells, which are called osteogenetic cells. So this is the first category of cell. The second category I'm writing here, they are called osteogenetic cells. Osteogenetic means they are the stem cells. Stem cells. And they give rise to the osteoblasts. So they are the ones which actually are producing the osteoblasts, which change into osteocyte, and they are eaten up by osteoclasts. So this is the main type of cells that we have. Arrangement we'll see a little later. Now, what is the matrix made up of? The matrix is hard and it is made up of two things. One is the protein part and there are salts which get deposited. So this is the organic part, protein, and then there are inorganic salts. The protein is osine. The protein is osine, and the salts are mainly two, calcium phosphate and calcium carbonate. These two, they combine and that makes the actually hard bony matrix. So the bone, hard bone, is made up of basically cells and this material which is there. Now, depending upon how these cells are arranged, we get two types of bones, compact bones and spongy bones. So now in the next part, what we'll do is, we'll enlarge this part, we'll try to see what is inside, and this is the compact bone which is in this part. The spongy bone that is in the head region or in the flat bones, it has slightly different arrangement of the cells. Cells, material, everything remains the same, only the arrangement is different. So in the next part, we'll try to enlarge this segment of bone and we'll see the arrangement of all the cells.